can't be very many people in Britain who don't recognise this by now. It's the Leyland Road train, which has been zooming across our TV screens practically every night lately in that very impressive series of TV ads. In fact, it cost about £30 million to build a brand new factory just for this. And if you fancy one as a family runaround, well, this complete rig will cost you about £35,000. But after all the ballyhoo and publicity, just how good is the road train? And to take up the theme of the ad, were we right to have faith? Well, with me is Pat Kennet, the editor of Truck Magazine, who's been keeping quite a close eye on the development of the road train. So Pat, $64,000 question, just how good is it?
Undoubtedly, it's a very advanced truck technically, and a very good machine indeed, as one would expect from the level of investment behind it. And it can be safely said that it's comfortably ahead of its competition in the market at this time.
Well, if it's ahead at the moment, how long is it likely to stay ahead, do you think?
That's a question of future investment, really, bearing in mind that the vehicle has to go through into the 90s and possibly up to the turn of the century, and it will require a certain amount of investment over those years to keep it ahead. But with that investment, it'll stay ahead.
So let's take a closer look at the ways in which a big truck like this has to compete. Because after all, if you or I are buying a new car spending about £3,500, well, it's a very agonising decision. So just imagine the sorts of things that a fleet manager has to take into account when he's buying one vehicle worth 10 times as much, and perhaps he's after a whole fleet in all. So Pat, what sort of things will the fleet manager be looking for?
Primarily, every truck operator is looking to see how much work he can get out of the truck and how little it costs him in doing that work. Every truck operator is interested in that and nothing else. From the serviceability point of view, which is a major factor in keeping the truck working, this truck has been designed from a clean sheet of paper upwards with that in view. There are dozens of items we could look at, but for examples, all the daily top-up points are all within easy reach here in the front. There's a special wiper motor with at least two times the life of any previous wiper motor, which can be serviced by just removing those two plugs a few seconds and you've changed the brushes on the wiper motor. The whole pedal pack, which is air operated of course, can be removed for service in about 20 minutes. You put a new one in, the truck goes out on the road earning its money, and the unit is repaired on the bench. Another interesting serviceability item is that the auxiliary instruments in the cab are all identical, so all, instead of having eight separate part numbers to keep in the stores, you just have one. They're all interchangeable.
What about running economy?
The engine characteristics are interesting on this vehicle. It's a low revving, slow burning type of engine, as we call it in the industry, and that means its fuel economy is exceptionally good, and also the exhaust emissions are very clean. Also, the aerodynamics of the cab are about 30% better than anything else on the road, and when at motorway speeds, a good half of your power goes into pushing air around, so if you can cut that down, you're saving a lot of fuel.
Well, now, Pat, you've been around trucks for a good many years. Have you got any criticisms of the road train?
Yes, there are a few detail items which I don't doubt will be developed out of it in due course, but there's a very annoying rattle on the gear lever, for example. A lot of people in the industry aren't too happy about the gearbox. That could be something we grow with, but there, apart from that, it's just niggling little items.
Okay, Pat, thanks very much indeed. Well, a lot of thought has been given to providing as much comfort as possible for the driver, and for that, let's take a look inside. The steps here, incidentally, are very easy to see and to climb up, perhaps not so much on the way up, but on the way down, more important. And the seat's comfy too, and if it isn't comfy first go, well, there are infinite variations of adjusting it, because this bit tilts and that bit tilts and you can move up and down. And also, this dial here is a sort of dial your weight knob, which means that you dial in what weight you are, and the suspension on the seat is adjusted to make it as comfortable as possible for you. And also the rake on the steering wheel can be altered too, looks sort of up or down. I think about there for me. Well, when I close the door, you can see there's plenty of space in here, room for a bunk at the back, if you want to have a sleep sometime during the journey. And the temperature's very cosy as well. In fact, they do say that it can be anything up to 20 degrees centigrade inside the cab. That's about 70 degrees in good old-fashioned Fahrenheit inside the cab, whereas outside it can be as low as minus 30 degrees centigrade, and that really is very cold indeed. And if the weather is that bad outside and you've got any emergency electric repairs to do, well, Here are all the fuses, and in fact all of the electrics are actually inside the cab, so there's no danger of corrosion from salt or anything else. Very important instrument here, this is the tachograph, which is compulsory on all vehicles of this kind from now on. This is a two-man tachograph, so two drivers can register their periods of either driving or working in some other capacity than driving or sleeping. So that's all registered there on a paper disc, which is behind there. The handbrake is very easy to operate. It can be locked off in this position. You can't knock it off by accident, but I'm just going to try a bit of driving, so I'll take it off and let you see. Just like that. This is a splitter gearbox, which means that there are 10 forward gears and 2 backward ones. And in fact, you only have to use the clutch and go in the normal way for the odd numbers. And for the even numbers, you can just use this flicker switch. But you'll see what I mean when I get going. Off we go. Gently does it. Now all I need to do to move up to the next gear is just flick this switch to press the clutch, and off we go, Bob's your uncle. In fact, there is no synchromesh on this gearbox, which surprises me, although apparently it's quite usual on these bigger lorries, so to move up to the next gear again is in fact quite hard and requires double D clutching. One other thing about the road train is that a lot of thought has gone into the design of the front of the cab, because I'm sure any of you who've ever seen a monster this size coming up behind you in your rearview mirror, it can look very aggressive. Well, they've designed the cab to look as friendly as possible so that it doesn't intimidate other road users. It's what the management call low aggressivity. Well, it's just as well, isn't it, that Leyland is only the guardian of our motoring industry and not of our language.